Hi, I'm Lady Charmaine, and you may know my next guest from Dallas Buyers Club and Transformers. And he's here today to talk about his new show starring Halle Berry entitled Extent. Help me welcome Mr. Michael O'Neill to the show. Welcome, Michael, to the show.
Thank you so much, Lady Charmaine. It's nice to be with you.
Now, you have a new summer series coming to CBS called Extent, starring Halle Berry. So first, I want you to tell us about the show and tell us about the character that you play.
Well, the show is based about 50 years into the future, and I play Halle's boss. I'm the head of what NASA has morphed into a private agency in the future in our story, and I send Halle on a 13-month solo mission as an astronaut into a quadrant of space that we know a little about, but not very much. And she's solo, and yet she comes back. She's not alone. Somehow or another, in the process of this mission, she becomes pregnant. And this is a woman who had struggled with fertility, and so that it's a complicated and suspenseful and very human, a very human story. There's nothing, you know, inaccessible about it. It's not something that we wouldn't recognize from our own lives and struggles. How do we balance, you know, work and family and changes in the planet that we don't recognize, or changes in our world that we don't recognize? You know, there are media things that happen, and I go, how did they do that? Where do you plug that in? So I think she's on a journey, and we're going to go with her in this next 13 weeks.
So is the journey, we're going to try to figure out how in the world did she get pregnant?
You know, you as an audience will know. You'll be privy to it. We won't be as the storytellers, which is an interesting dilemma for us to be in. You know, there's that old line from Hamlet: "There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than have been dreamt of in our philosophy." And it's a whole new world of possibility. When you think about where space travel has gone in the last 50 or 60 years, what are the possibilities in the next 60? So although we're science fiction, Lady Charmaine, I think an aspect of it is probability.
So why do you think this show was perfect for the summer?
You know, it's a new model that CBS has been very, very successful with. They did Under the Dome. And I think it's perfect for summer because it's a serial. It's a true serial. We're not solving something at the end of each episode. We are continuing to tell a story, and it's in chapters. I think it's a perfect time for us to be out there. There are no new shows. It's a traditional time of reruns and people not having new programming to watch. And CBS realized, wait a minute, there's tremendous appetite for people to have new stories being told. Mm-hmm. So that's their model, and we're going to try to fill it.
Okay. Now, what can viewers expect from this show, from all the other shows that are going to be debuting this summer?
Steven Spielberg, Halle Berry, a remarkable writer, Vicki Fisher, who's created a story in a world that, you know, we get to look at what does it mean to be human, and what makes us so, and how do we deal with loss, and how do we deal with gain, and how do we deal with the unexpected, and so it's how you deal with inspiration, and it's hopefully, you know, I'm not a good judge, Lady Charmaine, because it's so close to me. But I think that it's a story that's galvanizing for people to look at what is possible / probable in a way. And I think now's not a bad time to think about it.
Now, I got a question. What was it like for you to work with Halle Berry and Steven Spielberg? And we know Halle Berry is one of the stars. We normally know her from movies, and now we get to see her in television. So what was it like for you working with her?
Well, the hardest thing, to be honest, is just not to fall in love with her. Everybody knows she's a beautiful, beautiful woman. I think what people don't know about Halle is that she's probably one of the most gracious, generous people that I've been around in a long, long time. And it's who she is. It's not, you know, it's not a 15-minute cycle for her. She's a really, really good person. And I think it's one of the things that sort of radiates about her as a star. You care about her. You want to follow her journey. So for me to stand across from her in a scene, whether I'm, you know, in conflict with her or allied with her, she's just really, really available as an actor. And she, you know, that rising tide lifts all boats. She raises us up. She really raises us up as a cast. You know, I think we try to bring our better selves to this work.
And what was it like working with Steven Spielberg?
Visionary. You know, I mean, you want an opportunity. It's almost, you know, you think about Spielberg, mm-hmm. and it's the look at the sort of the book of work that he's done in the last 30 or 40 or 50, 40, well, I'm trying to think, 35 years or so. But you know, he just has such vision. And I think what he brought to this show was to make sure that it was emotionally true, emotionally available to people. You know, the world does change in 50 years. Our world has changed in the last 50 years. And yet there are things that are utterly recognizable from 1960 to 1970. You know, I look around my room and I can see a model car, or I can see, you know, a photograph or a tool of some kind or other. It's not that we've reinvented the world. We've tried to give an idea of what it may look like in 60 years. But the humanity of it, he made sure that we captured that we didn't stray so far afield in our exploration of space, that we didn't lose the human story.
And that's one thing I love about Steven Spielberg. You know, when you think about movies like E.T., and they're really touching, he can bring something that when you deal with space, but yet touches your heart, too. So that's why I look forward to definitely watching this television show, just to see how did him and Halle Berry come together and collaborate and make such a great show. Because it's always some type of story that's in there that's going to be gripping. So I look forward to seeing it. And I just want to thank you so much, Michael, for coming on the show. And I want to remind the audience to make sure you check out Extent. It premieres Wednesday, July 9th. Okay, check it out at 9 p.m. Eastern Pacific Standard Time. And Michael, my last question for you before we go, I know I got it like a minute. How is this character different from all the other characters you played on television? What's different about this one?
Complication. It's difficult to know at times whether Sparks is good or bad. Mm-hmm. There's a gray area because I'm so mission driven. I'm a man that's willing to paint outside the box to accomplish what needs to be accomplished. And the notion that they're both sides of the coin, you know, there's an old saying, you can't buy anything with one side of the coin. Well, these writers have explored both sides of Sparks, and that's been different for me. And then, you know, getting to work with this company of actors has been, it's always different.
Wonderful. There you have it. Extent premieres Wednesday, July 9th. Make sure you check it out. Thank you so much for joining me on the show today.
And with you.
Yes, it's airing on CBS. I want to make sure I remind everyone it's airing on CBS. Thank you so much, Michael. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Liz. Charmaine, you take care.
You too. Bye-bye.